I am Gurinder Chadha. I'm a writer, director and a producer. Blinded by the Light is a coming-of-age movie set in 1987 about a 16-year-old Pakistani kid who has a dream of being a writer, but his family are very poor, a lot of unemployment, Margaret Thatcher is in power, and there's not much of a future for young people at that time. And he's desperate to be a writer, but his parents need him to go out and get a proper job. But one depressing day, someone gives him a cassette, and it's a Bruce Springsteen cassette, and the words of Bruce Springsteen inspire him to keep going and to fight his dream. I have lots of favourite Bruce Springsteen songs, but I think I would say Jungle Land, because it's sheer cinema. It's a proper song with a beginning, middle and end, and it's very filmic, very cinematic. It tells the story of a character. It's really emotional. It goes through a whole gamut of emotions. Well, the woman that I think has been very inspiring to me is Maya Angelou. Because I read I Know Why the Caged Bird Sings, quite early on in my career. And she is someone who I think really personifies what struggle is and coming through it creatively and finding forgiveness and empathy for all the wrongs that were done to her. So I think Maya Angelou, for me, although she's not a filmmaker, she really is someone that I think is truly inspirational. But I also like the work of Jane Campion. I loved Angel at My Table when it came out, and I loved Sweetie. That was one of the first films I saw. Lots of filmmakers, lots of female filmmakers. It's important to support them all, really. Catherine Bigelow is amazing as a filmmaker. My good friend Mira Nair has made some cracking films. I think I love Andrea Arnold, I loved that I met her once and I said, has it been a new film? And she said, oh, it's really boring, she said, of Wuthering Heights. So I love her for her frankness, but I think she makes beautiful films. So yeah, a lot of women I support and admire. I don't know if I ever got blooming advice. I'm freaking had to struggle through my own stuff. I have to say there was one moment that was very important to me. And I was shooting something, and I had a male cameraman who was quite a bully. I was very early on in my career. And he was really grumpy, and he knew I was a very new director, but he was still being quite dismissive with me. And towards the end of the shoot, everyone was very tired, including me. And the gaffer, Ken Sykes, his name is. He's from here, he's from Manchester. Ken Sykes was the gaffer. He used to be a company called Bell Lighting. Oh God, I wish I could see Ken right now. So Ken Sykes was the gaffer on the film. And he had watched me during the whole thing. And although he was obviously working for the DP, and the DP was lovely, really. He was just a bit grumpy. And also, I was a first timer, so I was learning on the job. And everyone gets very emotional on set. But Ken Sykes saw me welling up. This was in the last sort of 3 days of shooting or something. And he slipped in next to me, and he said, I need a word with you. And he pulled me aside, he took me behind the stage, and he held my hand, and he said, don't you dare. Don't you give anyone the satisfaction of crying. Don't you dare. And of course I cried with him. But it was his kindness and the fact that he had watched everything that had been going on. And then put me back together again and sent me back out there. And I've never forgotten that. That was Ken Sykes, bloke, northern bloke from Manchester who did that for me. And I think that was probably the best lasting advice I was given, because because I've never forgotten it, and no one's ever put me in that position ever again in my 30-year career.